the Rebel Call Channel. Welcome to today's show, trending in the United States of America. Very fittingly, is the phrase "death to America," because of course it's trending in the United States because the government wants it to trend. And really, the only people who want death to America are the globalists. The only people who want death to America is Republican and Democrat, who were not elected in the first place, who were put in these positions of power to sabotage the United States of America. And that's why stories like death to America are allowed to trend. In fact, that is why stories like death to America are used as gaslighting measures in this country to bring about a global world order. So, for those of you that don't remember, the term death to America has been used loosely over the last couple of decades or so, but most notably was just brought about to most Americans' attention in the film Leave the World Behind on Netflix, which of course is nothing more than a movie that is just forward predictive programming. But you might remember this scene from Leave the World Behind.
Death to America. But this part, it definitely means death to America. Remember from a game I was playing.
So, of course, conveniently, they weren't shooting people for this massive events in this country, which has not been happening since they put Trump in power to bring about division in the United States of America. Death to America is trending because conveniently a citizen of the United States of America who happens to be Muslim was protesting, and of course this couldn't be some type of government operative, right? He's allowed to openly speak about death to America and death to Israel out in the streets and not be arrested for treason. For those of you that don't know, treason is still a crime in this country. Treason is supposed to be punishable by death, but it is a federal offense. So I would think when we're talking about treason, it really used to be like burning an American flag would be considered treasonous, but now I believe it's protected under the First Amendment. My right to speak is not, however. But burning a flag of a country that you live in is okay, if it's your country's flag. But to actually be in the streets calling about death, which sounds like a pretty serious threat to the country you live in, you would think would either result in a federal offense or at least a deportation of the person. But of course, what does it result in? Well, it results in that trending on Twitter. It results in that being used as a massive gaslighting tool because this is what they want by design. Now, I'm going to play for you this clip of this guy protesting, and I want you to keep in mind a few things when you see this clip. Of course, one of the headlines you see is death to America, death to Israel, because what they're doing here is they're very quietly, as I've been talking about, they're maneuvering conservative patriots in America to be side by side with Israel. Now, for anyone that understands what's going on, understands the New World Order infrastructure, understands the Bible, where the Bible talks about the synagogue of Satan, understands that when Israel became a state, okay, it was the year 1948. Let me repeat that. Israel declared its establishment as a state in 1948. And what that did was it gave globalists a place to build about their military-industrial complex without being questioned, of course. And most Christians out there are going to continue to be duped. So they're trying to, obviously, hold hand-in-hand America, patriots, and Israel side-by-side. Christians are obviously very easily duped into this. They have no idea. They don't know how to interpret scripture. They hear stuff like these speeches, but they get gaslit into being side-by-side. And now, thus, because of things like this and things that are happening in the mainstream media, they are now aligned against Muslims. All the stories about 9/11 have come back up by design to make people infuriated. And they're all looking at the wrong enemy. Because the enemy is really from within. And obviously the one controlling both sides of this conflict is Israel. And I want to point out Albert Pike's World War III blueprint that he talked about many years ago, because it's exactly what they're following right now. A third world war will occur between the political Zionists and the leaders of the Islamic world. The war must be conducted in such a way that Islam and political Zionism mutually destroy each other. Meanwhile, the other four divided on the issue will be constrained to fight to the point of complete physical, moral, spiritual, and economical exhaustion. It is being used as a division tactic here in the United States of America, as well as a herding tactic. Here is the speech that was given. And of course, there's some truth to what this guy is saying, but it's very likely that this guy himself is a government operative. But when he talks about the whole structure of the United States government needing to go, this is what they want you to feel. And I hear a lot of people out there who are truthers saying the same thing, like, we have to change this whole structure. And the reality of it is, it's not the structure of how this country is actually set up. It's the people who are in charge. Because the people who are in charge, the structure worked until, of course, they began rigging elections, which happened a long time ago. But now with the electronic election, it's just a complete joke. These people are all placed in these positions of power. The structure itself would actually potentially have the potential, I should say, to work. But the problem is that it's completely compromised. The Supreme Court, the Senate, the House, all of these people are members of secret societies. Every one of them guilty of treason are all in these positions. So the system is not broken. They're breaking the system. So listen to this guy talking about death to American people in the crowd, or chanting death to America. But instead of arresting the people for a federal offense, which would be treason, as they're doing this on American soil in Michigan, instead of doing that, what do they do? Well, they make it go viral on Twitter. Of course they do.
Now,
let
me come down right now. You probably want to
Why are not more protests on the International Day of Books? Why are they so anti-America? Why don't we just focus more on Israel and not talk so much about America? Gaza has shown the entire world why these protests are so anti-America. Because it's the United States government that provides the fund for all of the atrocities that we just heard about. And this is why Imam Khomeini would declare the International Day of Books. This is why he would say to pour all of your chants and all of your shots upon the head of America. Malcolm X said, and I quote, "We live in one of the rottenest countries that has ever existed on this earth. Tell Genocide Joe that has to go. It's the entire system that has to go. Any system that would allow such atrocities and such gallery to happen and would support it, such a system does not deserve to exist on God's earth." And so when these fools ask us if Israel has the right to exist, the chant "Death to Israel" has become the most logical chant shouted across the world today. Imam Khomeini recognized that Israel is an evil, secular, colonialist project. He realized it is a cancer, and he established this day. Israel, before this, brothers and sisters, was a sacred cow. Nobody would criticize Israel. Everybody was terrified of being anti-Semitic. Everybody's afraid. But now, the people of conscience, very openly, will criticize Israel. They recognize Israel for what it is. Israel is ISIS. Israel are, they are Nazis. They are fascists. They are racist. The people of Israel now know this.
From the river to the sea, Palestine will be free.
So this is Israel not understanding the Bible correctly. It talks about who is Israel? What is Israel? Nobody talks about the interpretations anymore of Israel. Nobody even really. I think a lot of Christians out there just assume Israel has been Israel since the years, you know, since God was here, and it's remained Israel. They don't realize that before 1948, it wasn't even Israel. It's the state of Israel. There's two separate things. They're the people of Israel and the state of Israel. And then the Bible tells us in the book of Revelation, there'll be those that claim to be and are not, are of the synagogue of Satan. And those are the people who are pulling the strings here and working all sides, all angles. And right now, you can see how they are trying to very strategically out there who are completely clueless. They're just as clueless if they're aligning themselves with Israel and not understanding the Bible correctly. They're actually aligning themselves with the people who truly want them to America, right? Do you mean books? You mean stuff is out there if you actually read the teachings of a lot of these rabbis? There's nothing they want more than to bring America down, and they're doing it, and it's happening. So to have Israel mixed into this doesn't matter at all, because they're actually aligning the people who should be waking up and starting a revolution to siding side by side with Israel. The people who are responsible for it all. And of course, the call at hate speech will probably give me a strike on the video, but it's a video that I wanted to do and needed to do, because they are attempting every way possible to bring America down via sabotage. And they want you to think that America is crumbling because of me and you, because of civilians being divided on issues. It's crumbling because the government is literally putting TNT everywhere and detonating it. And they're doing everything they can psychologically to gaslight us into civil war with one another. And they're using Israel, they're using Palestine strategically as another herding mechanism, right? Straights, gays, whites, blacks, Israel, Palestine, you name it. They're exhausting you to the point of submission, right? What was the quote? Meanwhile, the other nations, once more divided on this issue, will be constrained to fight to the point of complete physical, moral, spiritual, and economical exhaustion. And economical is another key term in there, right? The more that our government continues to aid all these other countries in these simulated wars that are really just wars on the civilians, the more that the infrastructure here in America crumbles, the more economically the United States of America crumbles, the more that they do things on the side to destroy the food supply chain, force everybody inside, locked down, businesses closed, people lose their jobs for not complying. All of this stuff is strategically done. And again, as long as you look at one another, as long as everybody is angry, everybody, Dems are angry, Republicans are angry, everybody's angry, but they're angry at the wrong person and people and groups. These people in power, Republican and Democrat, are doing this to us. And they can nuke this entire country, which is what they're planning on doing, not a literal nuke. They're nuking the infrastructure of this country by doing this gaslighting, by doing this division, and that's what they want to bring about. Death to America. So no surprise James Woods, of course, was one of the people who got this trending, because James Woods, somebody out of Hollywood who just, everybody loves James Woods, who's conservative because he puts up the American flag and don't tread on me, so everyone's like, oh yeah, he broke free from Hollywood. Nobody goes, how do you get into Hollywood in the first place? How do you gotta be in the secret societies, right? James Woods was also somebody who put out a lot of disinformation about the McMartin preschool, which is the thing that really woke me up. So James Wood is a place in my heart, and will always have a place in my heart, for misleading so many people about truth, which was the McMartin preschool. James Woods played in the HBO movie about it, even had many interviews talking about how it was a witch hunt and it was make-believe, but now he's, of course, a conservative. That event right there should have been the event that woke up people in the United States of America to the satanic underworld, and now he's one of those few celebrities in Hollywood that's aligned with the conservative movement, right? You see a lot of these, like, they're like C-level actors, which is done by design, right? It's like C-level actors pretending, oh, we're not allowed to be in movies anymore. They blacklisted us, and everything they tweet goes viral. They're allowed to have these huge presences on social media. They don't get censored. Of course they don't. Of course they don't, because they're working the conservatives. In fact, the more I think about it, the conservatives are worked more and under more deception than the actual Democrats. The Democrats are living in an alternate reality, because they're believing in all the lies they were told. So they're very easily manipulated, because they believe in the quote-unquote sciences they've been taught, the fake history of the world, right? The conservative side, the problem is that they think that they're awake. They think that Q is in a government op. I mean, at this point, it's amazing to me. It's amazing. They believe, oh, right, Q is in a government op. Nobody found out. They can't find out who's behind it and arrest him and do all this stuff, right? Yeah, Q is in a government op, and of course, all this stuff with aligning with Israel is exactly what they want. This is what I've been fearing for Christians for a long time. This is why I continue to do it, because I believe that many Christians are going to fall for great deceptions. I believe it's one of them. I believe maybe it's the greatest deception, right? Because think about it. If you read the teachings of a specific group of people that we're talking about, that worship Satan, that have all of these disgusting satanic acts in their books, and then you take God's chosen, when you take Christians who are saved by the blood of Christ, and then you get them to actually literally align themselves with Lucifer, right? Ultimately, you have Christians who are aligning themselves with the literal enemy of humanity. even realize it because they can't interpret scripture properly, which is part of the problem that we're all dealing with, right? The 501c3 churches are all aligned with political Zionism. And that's all done by design. That's why those people aren't silenced. That's why people like you are silenced. Why people like me are silenced. Why we constantly struggle to find places that we can speak openly. Because the truth is not allowed. But if you play into the left-right, if you play into death to America, these narratives of division, then you will be promoted like this man was into the algorithms on Twitter, on YouTube, everywhere else. Because as long as they can gaslight you into what they want to gaslight you into, you won't be arrested for treason. You will be promoted and trend the way they want you to trend because this is a psychological war. So, no correlation between death to America, leave the world behind, and now this story is out there. This guy's just speaking on a street in Michigan. He's talking about death to America. Literally, I mean, he's calling on, you know, is this a threat? I mean, look, I'm all for free speech, so I wouldn't say to arrest the guy. But based on everything that we see going on in this country, and look, I'm not talking about the stuff in the news because we know a lot of it's manipulated stories about Christian protests, the stuff that they do to gaslight. I'm talking about from personal experience being able to speak. Right? I'm talking about personal experience, not even being able to speak mysteriously in the shadows here on YouTube. Yet this guy's on national news, and the police don't go, hey, you know what? This guy was calling for death to America. That's a threat to other Americans. This guy could be a potential terrorist in this country. Maybe we should arrest him for treason, which is a federal offense. Is it still, you know, is guilt still death? What treason? I mean, it was at one point in time, right? No. Those aren't things that they want. People should be suspicious of that. They don't want to arrest this man. They want to promote this man. Because they ultimately all want death to America. That's the goal. And if they can keep you divided, they'll accomplish that goal. I thank everybody for being here. Hope you're all doing well. God bless you as always. And your family.